Now, who hasn't asked this question to themselves or to others? You know, what is your meaning of life? What is my meaning of life? You know, for the longest time, the purpose that I thought I had, that I believe I had, was to glorify God and to preach the word of God to everyone, as many people as I could. So, you know, they could, so in hope that they would develop a loving relationship with Jesus Christ, and that in itself would save them and salvation. They would reach, you know, get salvation and meet Jesus Christ after they die. And for the longest time, you know, I think I've had that mission since I was a kid. You know, my dad being a pastor and all, and me having been very strong conviction of that, very strong faith. You know, that was my purpose. That was my meaning in life for a long time. Then my faith got shattered. And I became an apostate. And after that, you know, it was a pretty hard struggle. Going from such strong spiritual faith to irreligion is not, well, at least in my case, was not an easy step. It was a very hard step and very depressing step. You know, I think at one point, you know, I was feeling very suicidal, and it's just like, well, if relationship with Jesus Christ is not true, it wasn't. I don't think my struggle with it was more of is it true or not? You know, is it scientifically backed up or not? That wasn't really my thing. The deal that I had was, is this relationship really the right thing for me? You know, because per you know, I grew to kind of not like God. You know, my apostasy, I guess, would be, you know, I wouldn't really say that it was from Christianity to atheism. It was more like from Christianity to anti-theism. You know, it was to the point where I was like, I don't care if God actually exists or not. You know, if he doesn't, then thank God that we don't have to go to hell. If he does, I will still choose to go to hell because I don't want to, you know, spend the rest of eternity to a God that allowed that to his creation. You know, it's pretty extreme, and you know, to Christian onlookers, is it'd be a very ridiculous and foolish sentiment or thought to have, I think. But that was how it was. And for me, from going from that strong conviction to that, it's just like, well, now then, what is the meaning of life? Nothing. There is no meaning in life. You know, my meaning in life was shattered. There was no reason to live. And the only reason, I guess, I haven't killed myself was because there are people, I guess, who still cared about me, you know, and they would be devastated if I killed myself, like my parents, you know. I'm an only child, so as an only child, if I kill myself, you know how devastating that would be to my parents. So in consideration of my parents, I tried to struggle and to live on, but then I came to kind of be enticed and appeal to the social work profession, you know, helping people. Or there was a lot after my faith was shattered and I no longer wanted to be a pastor or a missionary. The career path I could choose became like infinitely numerous. You know, I could be a teacher, a writer, I don't know, a whole bunch of different things, you know. And I took social work, you know, I'm majoring in social work. Who knows where I'll end up from this point, but I'm pretty definitely sure it'll be in some kind of area regarding social work. To, you know, I'm thinking of focusing on, you know, helping the homeless or helping people not become homeless. Maybe going into, and this is a tough area that I'm still not sure if I want to get into. You know, helping out the foster care system, helping out the prison population, certain along those lines, certain along those service provision areas as social work. You know, I know social work is really big on mental health counseling, clinical therapy, and substance abuse counseling and stuff of that nature. But that I don't really feel like I'm adequate enough. You know, I don't feel like I'm more well equipped to deal with those things. Although who knows, maybe I'll take those routes as well. But point being, you know, then I became to kind of think of purpose in life as, well, other people would be my purpose in life, to help people, to change the world, you know, the cliche phrase would be. But then, I really came to think about what this changing the world means. I watched this Japanese drama. Let me see if I could remember the name of it. It was, oh, this was, I have it written. It was Watashi Tachi no Kyokasho, which I guess, I don't know if this is correct, but translation for that is our textbook. And it was a fascinating Japanese drama. I didn't watch all the episodes of it because I watched it on mysoju.com. And mysoju.com is like a portal network. It has all the videos from like Daily Motion and Video Daily and stuff like that. But due to copyright reasons, some episodes were taken out and removed. So I wasn't able to watch like every episode. But I still got a really good glimpse of it. And the drama, I don't want to talk about the drama. I just want to talk about what made me think about philosophy is the beginning of the drama and the ending of the drama ask this question: can you change the world? And the beginning of the drama is this little girl that asks the question, and the little girl, the whole drama is about her death and the lawyer trying to get retribution for her death. And in the end of the drama, that same question is asked to the classroom of high schoolers: can you change the world? And different high schoolers answer this question in various different ways. I thought that was really interesting, the perspectives that these students had about changing the world. And of course, there's the optimistic view that, one person can indeed change the world given the right passion, given the right circumstances, given the right setting, and can improve the world. Like you think of people like Martin Luther King Jr., Gandhi, the president, with the right position, the right Stalin, he changed the world, not for the better, probably. Although maybe in industrial sense, kind of, he did give, I don't know. Anyway, one person can change the world in that way if you think of a terse, if you think of that perspective. But then another student was like thinking of in a more generalist sense, like, can you change the world? Well, perhaps if you have position, but as an average Joe, what can you really change about the world? You can't really change the world, or maybe you can change a part of the world, but can you really change it? There was that. And then this was the interesting perspective brought on by one other student was, what if, what if you can change the world? Is that really beneficial? Isn't that kind of egotistical and condescending that one person's view changes the world? That, why is it that what he thinks correct? Well, I've stumbled on words here. But it's kind of like going saying, one person's view of the world may not even be correct. Should we give that person the right to change the world, such as Hitler, such as, it's not right. It's very egotistical and arrogant for one person to believe that he can change the world to his own liking, And these are, I think it's a really interesting question. And that's when I started to kind of develop my philosophy, I guess. It's just that I think I can sum it up in kind of one sentence, is that I think my purpose in this world, my existence, is not to change the world. I don't think I'm even capable of doing that, but I don't really think it'd be even beneficial to do that. But to perhaps, to put in a phrase, improve the world one life at a time. I improve one person's life, I'm improving the world, I think. Maybe by a tiny increment, but I am. And that's the reason I live. To live, interact with other people, and to hope that my existence at least helps someone, at least one person. And it's a very conflict ridden kind of balance here, my philosophy is, because at one, to survive, I am my survival alone, 3 meals a day or 2 meals a day, this chicken taco for my survival, this chicken's dead, So I've actually killed a living being so that I can live. That's one concept to think about. So I think in this planet Earth, because I breathe out carbon dioxide, I am unintentionally, kind of hurting the planet, as there if there are less trees to actually withhold. So you know what I'm saying. So my existence actually kind of hurts the world. and makes the world better, worse. But I want to counterbalance that. I want to counteract that and make sure that my life, my existence, helps other people. And I think that is my philosophy. It's not to change the world, because I don't think I can, but to improve the world, one life at a time. I think perhaps by the time I die, if I can remember, just remember that I really helped out one person's life, or two people's lives, or how many people's lives that I touch, and I really improve, I think I could die a satisfactory death. And that's my philosophy.